Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Marhaban, you are welcome to this class. So the purpose of this class is to explain or to give a brief introduction to Arabic verbs, as verbs are very important in any language. So in Arabic language, when we understand these verbs and how they are formed and their uses, it will make us or it will make it easy for us to understand the Quran, the Hadith, or any Arabic text, and it will also aid us in our Arabic conversation. So when we are talking about the Arabic verbs, we are talking about three things basically. The first one, we are talking about az-zamanu. We are talking about az-zamanu, which means time or tense. The second one, we are talking about al-adadu. Al-adadu, which means number. And the third one, we are talking about al-ashakhsiyya. We are talking about the person. Is it first person, second person, or third person? So these are the three basic things that we talk about whenever we are talking about verbs in any language, and Arabic in particular. So when we are talking about the first one, we can say al-azamanu, that is time. So there are three times in Arabic language or Arabic verb. So we are talking about the first one, al-fi'lu al-madi. Then the second one, al-fi'lu al-mudari'. The third one, al-fi'lu or fi'lu al-amri. Fi'lu al-amri. So that is the first thing that we need to note. Then the second one, when we are talking about al-adadu, al-adadu, we are talking about three things as well. So we have al-mufrad, which means the singular. Al-mufrad, which means the singular. Then we are also talking about al-muthanna. Al-muthanna, al-muthanna, which means the dua, that is two person. Then you have al-jam'u, al-jam'u, that is the plural. And plural in Arabic starts from three upward. So for two, you have al-muthanna, which means dua, when two persons do something. Then when we are talking about verb, we also talk about the person, that is the shakhsiyya. So we talk about al-mutakallimu, al-mutakallimu, which means the first person. Then we also talk about the al-mukhatabu, al-mukhatabu, which means the second person. Then we also talk about al-ghaibu, al-ghaibu, which means the third person. And among the things that we should talk about when we are talking about verb or noun in Arabic is when we are talking about al-jins, that is the sex. We are talking about male or female, that is masculine or feminine. So in that case, we have al-mudhakkaru, al-mudhakkaru, which means masculine. Then we have al-mu'annathu, al-mu'annathu, al-mu'annathu. And al-mu'annathu means the feminine. Then we can also have ghayru aqil, ghayru aqil. Ghayru aqil is neutral gender, neutral gender. Barakallahu fikum. So this is a summary of the things that we have to learn in Arabic verb. So as we have mentioned earlier, that they are basically three, but you can add the other one which we have mentioned. So you can have al-azamanu, which means tense, where you have al-madi, al-amru, and then al-mudari'. Then you can have al-adad, which means the singular, or the dua, or the plural, al-mufradu, al-muthanna, or al-jam'u. Then you also talk about the person when you are talking about al-mutakallim, which means the first person, al-mukhatab, the second person, then al-ghaib, the third person. So the fourth thing is when you are talking about al-jins, when you are talking about al-mudhakkar, which is the masculine, or al-mu'annathu, or al-mu'annathu, which is the feminine, or you talk about ghayru aqil, that is the neutral gender. Barakallahu fikum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.